So today's lecture video on DNA, basics of central dogma. Here you see the conversion from DNA to mRNA and to polypeptide, replication, transcription, translation, and reverse transcription. These are the term which said central dogma. Nucleotide, which is a unit for the DNA molecule. It is based of nitrogen bases, purine and pyrimidine. Here you see the structures. And please note down the position of the amino and oxy groups. And IUPAC name I have given. Now you see the DNA molecule which remain within the nucleus. Only in a chromatin structure. And in the cytoplasm there is lot of histone molecules. So it, in course of time, it changes into chromosome packaging and chromosome formation. So DNA molecule undergoes the most reliable semi-conservative model of replication, and this actually completes within the S phase of the cell cycle. Now we will concentrate on the intermediate step, that is transcription, which from DNA to RNA, and here is a strand of mRNA. Now you see the DNA structure. DNA is a three basic forms, A, B and Z. Here we are highlighting in our class B form of DNA molecule. Here you see every turn has 10.4 nucleotide base pairs. So base pairs per turn is given here 10.5. diameter within the two strand is 2.37 nanometer. I have shown the conversion, and the pitch rise from the two consecutive nucleotide base pair is 0.34. so if you convert, you will see this 34 angstrom in the whole turn, the length of the turn. Now you see the basic, very important thing, which is the main of discussion, the protein synthesis. That means the third portion of the central dogma, translation. Here you see, I have shown a very simple diagram with the mRNA 5' and 3', and within the mRNA there is some 3-letter codes, and these 3-letter codes are called codon, which comes from this genetic code. I have shown the basic pattern here. Few important amino acid I have shown: UCAG, UCAG, and first letter code UCAG in the very left, horizontally vertically line placed. Here you see various amino acid, and UGA, these are the stop codon. So you see here the amino acid, first with the help of amino acid TRNA synthetase, with the help of the ATP energy, and it get attached with the amino acyl AMP, that means synthetase, amino acyl synthetase complex with amino acyl AMP. Now you see the adenine base is shown, ribose sugar is shown, and the phosphate group is, with the help of diester bond, it bonded with a amino acid. So it is in the 3' end, and 5' end is a 5' terminal phosphorylated tRNA, which base pair, or which is attached with a anticodon, and this anticodon specifies the amino acid. So in this way the reaction and the whole process help to form this translation process, initiation. And now we see the whole video here. Thank you very much.